From our town to yours, the Statler Brothers Show, starring the Statler Brothers with their special guests, Jimmy Dean, Marsha Thornton, David Hamilton, along with Janie Fricke, Rex Allen Jr., the Cowboy Symphony Orchestra, the Bill Walker Orchestra, and me, Sherry Page. And now, the most awarded act in the history of country music, the entertainers on and off the record, Harold, Phil, Jimmy, and Don, the Statler Brothers.
I'm video facial historian, I'm Shirley Jean Burrell. I've known her since God only knows and I won't tell. I caught her the first time she stumbled and fell. And surely she knows me just as well.
I can tell you her birthday and her daddy's middle name. The uncles on her mama's side are the ones they don't blame.
What she's got for Christmas since 1952. And that's only the beginning of the things I could tell you. I'm the official historian of Shirley Jean Brown. I know her since God only knows and I won't tell. I caught her the first time she stumbled and fell. And surely she knows me just as well.
I can tell you her favorite song and where she liked to park. Why to this very day she's scared of the dark. How she got her nickname and that star behind her gate. If there's anything you need to know about Shirley, just ask me.
I know where she's ticklish and her every little quirk. Funny she don't read and her number at work. I know what she stands for and what she won't allow.
The only thing that I don't know is where she is right now.
I'm the official historian on Shirley Jean Brown. I've known her since God only knows and I won't tell. I caught her the first time she stumbled and fell. And surely she knows me just as well. Oh, surely she knows me just as well.
And welcome to Saturday Night with the Statler Brothers. I'm Don.
And I'm Jimmy.
I'm Phil.
I'm Ralph Emery.
No, you're not Ralph Emery.
Well, you ain't either.
Well, I never said I was. Okay.
Well, it says right here in my coat I'm Ralph Emery.
Well, then you must have the wrong coat on. Well,
that's funny, because down inside of my pants it says Shotgun Red. Maybe I'll go change clothes.
No. You keep them on. You look good in cartoon clothes. I
Thank
like
you
that.
Very much. Nice. I appreciate it.
All right, it's time for some questions from the audience. We're going to do that every night. And so if you'll bring the questions out, we'll see
Sharon,
what we can
bring
for that.
Bring us a question right here. Here we go.
All right, you Sharon. Bet.
Yeah,
thank you.
Sure.
Thank
you, Sharon.
Just one card again?
Oh, you want more? There's
yeah.
more.
Yeah.
Tamara? You're done.
They each carry one card at a time?
They're union.
They're union.
I don't want them carrying anything heavy.
I said, what union do they belong to?
AOTW.
What's that stand for?
Anyone they want.
All right. You're probably right about
can that. You understand that?
I can understand that.
I thought you could.
Questions. All right, hey, this is interesting. Look at here. This says, how do you decide who stands where when you sing?
All right, That's an interesting question.
Yeah.
It's kind of a long story, but I guess y'all got time to listen to this, don't you?
Yeah.
Thank you. We do stand different from other groups, other quartets, if you're familiar with any of them. In fact, most usually, the bass man, my position would be over on that end.
Right.
And we used to stand that way. Let me show you how we did it. Here we go. Come on. Okay. Now, when we stand the way everybody's supposed to, like that, then Jimmy plays the guitar in front of Don's face. So we decided maybe they should give me the guitar. So,
there you go.
They did. And we worked this way for about 6 months.
Okay, something like that.
And then realized I couldn't play the guitar. So I gave it back to Jimmy.
All right.
And we decided that maybe the problem was that we needed to stand a different way. So we stood like this. Now, the guitar is not in Don's face, but it put something else in the face of the audience.
Yeah.
That wasn't right, so we decided that maybe we should stand like this. And that's the way we started standing this way.
I'm too tired to do any more questions.
That's
got to be it. All right, folks, the show moves on, and what a show it's going to be. It's going to be Jimmy Dean, Marsha Thornton, the comedy of David Hamilton, not to mention our own, Rex Allen Jr., Janie Fricke, the Cowboy Symphony Orchestra, the Bill Walker Orchestra, and the sweet voice of Sherry Page. So don't move. This will all be continued in a matter of seconds.
His mama wanted him to become a preacher. Instead, he's a rising country star. Tracy Lawrence on stage Tuesday on TNN.
This young lady can best be described as all-American. Her daddy was a mailman, and her mother sang soprano in a gospel quartet. She says of herself, "I never thought of anything else but singing." And once we heard her, we can't think of anything else but singing either. Ladies and gentlemen, Marsha Thornton.
I'm getting tired of these lonely nights. I'm turning all shades of blue. I think I should grab me the fastest train and ride.
This man you're about to see is known as a balloonist extraordinaire.
That means he takes balloons and makes them into funny shapes.
The balloons you'll see tonight were once wild and free.
This guy captures and tames balloons, and they'll do anything he tells them to.
So here with his wonderful world of balloons is David Hamilton.
Thank you. Captures and tames balloons. Well, the balloons are captured right here in my pocket. Being tame, I'm not exactly certain of yet. Let's begin to inflate some of them and see what might happen. I sure hope I don't blow my brains out doing this evening. One. Five of them all together is what I need to get started. You like the fancy one-handed knot? Yeah. Whoopsie-daisy, I missed one of them. I spoke just a tad bit too soon. Perfect, just right. This is the largest struggle. It's pretty tough, but someone has to do it, and I've been into inflation all my life. Five balloons, that's where I needed to be, and now the beginning of a little story about myself, my grandmother, and a day out at the fair. You see, when I was just a little kid, my grandmother took me out to the fair the very first time. It seems that while we were there, I was the kind of a child that was asking for things all of the time. It was like, Grandma, I need to have a snow cone right now. Grandma, how about some cotton candy? Grandma, a bag full of peanuts, a caramel apple. Now it's a hot dog, Grandma, something cold to drink. And finally, before we left, Grandma, please, Grandma, just one more ride on the merry-go-round. Well, my grandmother always told me that experience turned her into a total basket case. She decided she wasn't going to take me out to the fair by herself anymore. Made my mom go along all of the time. Well, after just about a half an hour, Mom was doing a little hollering of her own, something like, David, if you don't stop asking for things all of the time, you're going to drive me quite bananas. You've probably had a similar experience yourself. Well, as you can see, that special balloon was a basket to be filled with fruit. The bananas are inside. Some more fruit we'll need to add. Something blue this time with 15 or 16 little bubbles in it. And we should end up with the most perfectly proportioned cluster of grapes you've ever seen in your whole entire life. Beautiful grapes, aren't they? Oh, no. I did that entirely wrong. It turned out to be a poodle dog, but I do know how to turn poodle dogs into grapes. All you do is turn their head around, tie their nose and tail together. Never do this with your dogs at home. They really don't like it. And then roll it inside out. Oh, it's such a struggle to do that with a poor little puppy dog. But we do have our cluster of grapes. Whoops. Now there's a bit more room left in the basket, so one more piece of fruit we can add. Something green this time. Obviously not the right shape for a pear. Much too small for a watermelon. So instead it will be the beautiful green, delicious apple. Now you may be wondering why the apple is green instead of red. That's because the red apples look so delicious everyone tries to eat them. And you should never eat balloon fruit. It will give you gas. Something red for the basket as well. Not for cherries, strawberries, or for raspberries. Instead, a beautiful ribbon to go all the way up on the top. A great gift for someone in our audience tonight, gang. Yeah. For you? Yeah. Thanks for being with us. God bless you all. Bye-bye.
The Statlers and Jimmy Dean will all be here when we return.